In this tutorial, I have blurred the moving face of the person, but without hiding the other face on the front. To do it, I will search blur and drag the mosaic, Gaussian, or camera blur over the clip. Please note that you can click window to activate effects panel and effect controls panel. Select ellipse shape in effect controls, temporarily reduce the mask opacity. Select mask to show its guidelines. Resize and reposition the mask in program monitor to fit it over the face of the gentleman. I will bring the playhead at the start of the clip. In effect controls panel, select the mask, then click on the forward track button. Premiere Pro will analyze and track the face movements. I will stop here because Premiere Pro has failed to track the face when it starts moving behind the statue. I will bring back the playhead on the point where the face starts touching the shoulder of the statue. I will select and delete the unwanted keyframes next to the position of playhead because I will recreate those keyframes one by one. Playhead is now positioned where the face of the gentleman starts touching the left shoulder of the statue. For close-up view, I will increase the area of program monitor. I will also increase the zoom level and through sliders make the intended portion visible in program monitor. Now I will keep pressing this one frame track button and it will keep moving the mask over the face while adding one keyframe on each click in timeline view. Because the blue line has come over the statue shoulder, I will add a new point over the shoulder and also adjust other vertex points to keep the mask away from the shoulder. Each vertex point has two handles, this one and this one. You can drag, stretch, contract, and move each handle to create a smooth curve. Now I will click one frame track button to move forward the mask and face. Again, I will adjust the position of vertex point to avoid blur over the statue shoulder. I will repeat this process while adjusting the mask position through vertex points and their handles. As now the face of the gentleman touches the face of the statue, now I will precisely adjust the mask outline around the face of statue. After this outline, I will not move one frame track button because it also moves the mask with the face. Here I only need to move forward the face of the gentleman. To do this, move the playhead slowly either in timeline or in timeline view. After moving face of the person a few frames forward, you can see that extra mask portion behind the face will look bad in playback. You can notice that as I change the values of vertex points, Premiere Pro has created a new keyframe in timeline. In playback, you can see that the mask starts shrinking as the face moves forward. Now move the face a few frames forward. Here you can see that the lips of the person are not blurred. If I also want to blur the lips without disturbing the hair of statue, so I will further zoom into the area and use sliders to bring the specific portion in front. I will add two more points near the edges of hair. Then I will stretch the central point to create a narrow straight over the lips. I will adjust its blur area by adding more vertex points and fix the curves through handles. Please note that when the mouse pointer adopts the shape of a pen, you can click to add a new vertex point. To delete a point, press Ctrl, bring mouse pointer over a point, and when the minus sign appears beside pen, click on the point and it will be deleted. However, you should be very careful and must not delete the previously added points. For example, if I delete these two original vertex points, this action will deform the mask shape at all earlier locations. So, I undo this deletion of points. Now, lips will also blur. Let me restore the previous zoom level of program monitor. Now, I will further close the mask points on the right side and adjust the handles. Now move the face further behind the statue while adjusting the mask shape. Now you can view the recent changes in playback. Now move the face to other side of statue. If this mask has only few vertex points, Then you can drag this same mask to the other side of the statue. However, I will not take it to the other side because this mask has too many vertex points and it will take extra time for readjusting the shape of mask. Therefore, I would prefer to add a new mask here. I would adjust the size and position of mask over the face of the gentleman. Now in effect controls, these settings control the values of mask 1 and these tweaks control the values of mask 2. The first mask is still visible, but don't worry. I will share the method to hide it. Turn on the toggle animation button of mask path of mask 2, which will create the first keyframe. Select the mask 2 and keep moving playhead while at the same time adjusting the mask values to hide face of the gentleman. If necessary, you can add new vertex points and fix the curves of the control points so that the mask covers the moving face of the gentleman. Now, as the complete face has come out of the statue, it is safe to move the mask and face at once. So, click one frame track button and keep repeating this action while at the same time adjusting the blur over face of the gentleman. Here, if the path is too long, you can also apply fast forward automatic tracking option as I did in the first mask. Now I can also increase the opacity of the mask 1. Now playback and adjust the mask shape if necessary. But here is one problem, that the mask on both sides of the statue is continuously visible, which looks bad. First, I will hide this unnecessary mask. Bring playhead over the last keyframe of the mask 1. Click the toggle animation button beside opacity. It will create a value keyframe at the playhead location next to the property of mask opacity. Please note that to show value keyframes, you must have expanded the opacity property by clicking on the triangle button. Now move playhead and add a second value keyframe closer to the first keyframe. Now click on the line of value keyframes after second keyframe and drag it downwards. Meanwhile, in program monitor, you can see that unnecessary mask 1 has now disappeared. In playback, you can also see that now the mask 1 is not visible when you play forward. Using the same method, I will also hide the unwanted portion of mask 2. Please watch while I do it. This video uses blur and keyframes. To master all the blur and keyframe functions, you can watch these videos, links in description. You can also watch tutorial video for hiding some sensitive text in a clip. You will lose nothing if you hit the like and subscribe button. You can see that now the face of moving person is perfectly blurred while passing behind the face of statue. I hope you have learned something new in this tutorial. Thanks for watching.